What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you are new. I'm Imani Murray, and this is my YouTube channel where I share social media tips and tricks to help brands and businesses improve their social media. And today we're talking ways you can use the InShot app to improve your social media. So a few months ago, I posted a video all about the top apps you should be using for your Instagram, and of course I listed InShot. InShot is my go-to. It is one of my favorite apps, and I just wanted to create another video just going more in depth about how you can use the app to really improve your social media, to make your, just to up your social media. This is not a tutorial on how to use the app. This is just ways and the features that you can up your social media. And we're not just gonna focus on Instagram. We're talking Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. If you wanna create content with Pinterest, pretty much any social media out there, InShot app will work. Not to mention, it is Android and Apple friendly. So all my Android people out there, you can use it. I use it on my iPhone and my iPad. So the InShot app is an editing app. I use Premiere Pro to edit all my YouTube videos, but for everything else, as far as social media, I use InShot. It's literally my go-to. It's a one-stop shop go-to editing on the go app, honestly. But first, before we actually get into the different ways, there are three different types of content that you can edit within the app. There's videos, pictures, and collages. So whatever kind of content you want to create, you want to edit, this is the app for you. So let's get into it. So the first way you can up your content on social media with this app is by utilizing the canvas feature. So that includes the ratio, zoom, and background options. So the ratio option offers so many different sizes formatted for Instagram posts, Instagram story, TikTok, Reels, YouTube, IGTV videos, Facebook posts, Facebook banners. The list goes on. There's so many different formats on here that you can choose from so that your content is formatted correctly on whatever social media app you're using. So next to the ratio option is zoom. So it's pretty self-explanatory. You can zoom in your content if you wanna zoom in, zoom out. You can align your content to the left of the screen or to the right of the screen. You can have it so that it fills the entire canvas. So definitely you could play around with that. And then next to the zoom option is the background, where you can have a blurred background, you can pick a colored background, patterns, gradient. You can upload your own image as a background. There's so many different options, especially if you're somebody that shares your tweets or somebody else's tweet to Instagram or to Instagram story. This is probably going to be one of your favorite options out of this app, because you can go ahead and crop the tweet within the app and then add a background. So if you want to do gradient, you can go ahead and select gradient. The cool thing about the gradient option, you can change which direction the gradient goes just by selecting the color that you want and then clicking it until you see what you like. So whenever, because I'm that person that shares tweets to my story all the time. Whenever I am sharing a tweet, I go ahead, go into the app, I crop it, I pick either a solid background or I pick my, I don't want to call it branded, but my background that I like to use whenever I am sharing some type of tweet or some type of screenshot, or if I'm announcing a new video, I will go ahead and put my YouTube thumbnail on a background, and voila, I can share it to my Twitter, I can share it to my Facebook page, I can share it to my Instagram story, all of the above. So ratio, zoom, background allows you to format your content so that it looks good and it's optimized for whatever app you're using. So after you've gone ahead and formatted your content to fit whatever social media app you're going to use, you may want to go ahead and put some effects or filters on it. So of course InShot has that option where you can apply different types of filters, effects, and adjust it, whether you want to adjust the brightness or the contrast, saturation, any of the above. I personally have the free option, the free version of this app. I don't really care to pay for apps. And so it offers, to me, in my opinion, it offers good enough filters and effects to play around with. Of course, if you want to up it even more, you can go ahead and purchase the app. Now, the next feature is probably my favorite feature within this app, and that's the speed option. So I love a good time lapse. I time lapse pretty much everything all day, every day. If you follow me on Instagram, you know I love sharing time lapse on my story. So I created, well, I recorded my time lapse in the iPhone or iPad camera app, and then I upload it to InShot. Sometimes when I upload it, I'll slow down the video to give it like a stop motion effect. Or if I just have a regular video that I want to speed up or slow down, you can do that in the app as well. You can also reverse it. Android users, I don't know if you guys can do time lapse in your camera app, but you can go ahead and upload the video to the app, to the InShot app, and just speed it up, and it kind of gives the same effect. So the next feature that is probably one of my favorite features, my second favorite feature in the app, is the transitions option. I love a good transition. Transitions up your video a little bit more. It switches things up a little bit. So I love a good transition. Once again, I have the free option, but there's a good enough transitions in the free option for me. You can also make it so that if you have multiple transitions in your video, you can have them all be the same by clicking the double check on the left side of the screen. When I'm editing like my reels or whatever, I usually, like I said, I edit it in the InShot app, and I'll use a basic transition and call it a day. I don't see a reason to pay for the app, but you never know. Some people like to spend money, so go ahead. And it's also, if you're doing like IGTV or YouTube, like I said before, you can go ahead and incorporate the basic transitions into your video. So the fifth way you can up your content with this app is by incorporating their graphics. So that includes the text and the stickers that they offer. They have so many different types of stickers, like GIFs and GIFs, or however you pronounce it. Different little like dancing animals or little different things that you can use to just make your video fun. You can also upload your own sticker. So when I'm editing my reels and it's a reel that's connected back to a YouTube video, so I'll upload a YouTube logo with a transparent background, and I'll add my channel name. And so I combine them and then kind of like watermark or make that my YouTube logo. So when people see my video, they know where to find my YouTube channel. Or you can use the text option to watermark your content so that somebody isn't stealing your content without giving you credit. Because that happens a lot on social media. So you still want to be able to get your credit, even if they're not tagging you or anything like that. So after you've done all of this, after you've formatted the content, you've put some effects, you added graphics, you sped it up, you slowed it down, all of the above, you probably want to add some music, right? So of course you can do that within this app. They offer copyright free music. You can also upload your own audio. For those of you that don't have music on your Instagram, like your Instagram story or Instagram reels, this will be your best friend, because you can download whatever audio you want to use and then import it into the app and then trim it however long you want to trim it. If there's a certain piece of the audio you want, you can go ahead, align it with the video, and then export it and then upload it to Instagram. And if you're lucky enough, when you upload it to your reel, Instagram may recognize the song and populate your reel in that audio reels page versus it just saying such and such original audio. So that happened to my client. I think she had one or two videos that was able to populate in an audio reels page, even though she doesn't have the audio option. So that's just like a little cheat code if you want to be able to use music on your reels, because nobody wants a boring reel with no music. It's also good if you are doing like a YouTube intro or like I said, IGTV, or any type of content that you want to incorporate music. This is a good way to do that. And of course, there's so many different other features within the app, like cropping pictures and videos, rotating, so many different other features that you can use to up your social media. These are just some of my favorite that I use. It's free. It's user friendly. You can use it on Apple products. You can use it on Android devices. You need to go ahead and download this app. This is not a sponsored video, but I literally recommend this app to everybody, whether they know what they're doing on social media or not. That is my go-to app. If somebody's like, oh, how did you do that? Oh, InShot. InShot is usually nine times out of 10, I'm answering them with InShot. So get you that app. It'll it'll really help you when it comes to your social media. So that's all for today's video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. As always, follow me at Itimani Murray. And let me know if you use the app or if you're going to download the app and what's your favorite feature about the app. And yeah, thank you for watching. I will see you in my next video.